I'll start with what do I mean by tobacco harm reduction. It's a concept that's been known for many years, for example, in road safety, wearing helmets on bicycles or seatbelts on cars. And the question is, can it be applied to the risks associated with tobacco, particularly cigarette smoking? I'll talk about the science program that we've had running with 1,500 scientists around the world, and particularly my group in Southampton in the United Kingdom, which is around 400 scientists and biologists and chemists and clinical researchers. Then I'll give you some data that relates specifically to smoking. The idea that you can reduce the risk caused by cigarette smoking by introducing new products that were lower in toxicant levels has been around for a long time. So this report comes from 2001. And it's based on the idea that we know the risks of smoking are what is called dose-related. So the more you smoke and the longer you smoke, the higher the risks you are. And if you stop smoking and therefore reduce that exposure, the risks go down.